Thank you. 1930s brought exciting changes to Hawaii. Attracted a million visitors in a single year. And within 5 years, that number has doubled. We became a popular destination for conventions, including the medical convention. And here to sing about that prestigious profession are Bill, Mike, Chris, and Glenn. Ladies and gentlemen, Funny Bone.
Stresses, every surgeon takes. We'll Kimo.
Kimo, he's the one that works over at the obstacle factory.
That's the one that guy's always making a scene, getting himself in trouble. Last week, he falls into a lens grinding machine.
Oh my gosh, is he all right?
Now he's fine. But you know, he made a spectacle of himself.
Theater featured films with artists like Rudolph Valentino and Mary Pickford, played host to concerts, New York musicals, and local productions. In the 60s and 70s, however, the entertainment scene shifted to Waikiki, and theaters with names like The Princess, The Liberty, and The King all shut down. In 1984, the Hawaii Theater closed her doors after 62 years of operation. But a group of citizens rallied the community to restore and save the theater. And after years of fundraising and restoration, she reopened her doors in April of 1996. And the first show in the restored theater featured The Sounds of Aloha.
Shout it now, there's no one who can doubt it now. So let's let all the world. Thank you. afternoon, and would you please help me in thanking the people who made it so special? Our Sound of Aloha players, Eli Jure as a kangaroo, and Adam and Gentle Bade as Statler and Waldorf. Our chapter quartets, residents. And Cuddy Bone. Under the direction of Kaimi Talakai, the Honolulu Boy Choir. Hawaii's own Prince of Comedy, Frank DeLima. Our 2010 International Gold Medalist Quartet, Stormfront.
Gentlemen, under the direction of Mr. Rob Hartley, the Sounds of Aloha.